Israel. Yes, God is real, for he the washed and made me whole. Yes, his love for me, hallelujah, is like pure gold. Hallelujah. Yes, God is real, for I feel him in my soul. Sing with me tonight, hallelujah. Oh, God is real. He real to you, hallelujah. He's real in my soul. Let's sing tonight, hallelujah. Yes, God is real, for he the washed and made me whole. Well, his love for me, hallelujah, is like pure gold. Glory to God. Yes, God is real, for I feel him in my soul. Come on, saints, hallelujah. My God is real. I love him tonight, hallelujah. He's real in my soul, hallelujah. Yes, God is real, for he the washed and made me whole. Yes, his love for me is like pure gold. Y'all know that one, don't y'all? Hallelujah. Yes, God is real, for I feel him in my soul. Do you feel him tonight? Hallelujah. My God is real. Hallelujah. He's real in my soul. Glory, hallelujah. Yes, God is real, for he the washed and made me whole. Yes, his love for me is like pure gold. I can't do without him, hallelujah. Yes, God is real, for I feel him in my soul. One more time, hallelujah. My God is real, hallelujah. He real in my soul. Why is he real? Hallelujah. My God is real, for he washed and made me whole. What kind of love does he have? His love for me, hallelujah, is like pure gold. Oh, yeah. Yes, God is real, for I feel him in my soul. Hallelujah. Amen. We know he's real tonight. Amen. And he's washed and made us whole. Amen. His love for us is like pure gold. Can the church say amen? And I'm just so glad that he loved me when I didn't love myself, when I didn't know what true love was. Amen. Jesus is a friend like no other. His love goes beyond anything that we can ask to think. And we certainly are thankful tonight that he has given us this great love. And I'm also thankful tonight that we have certainly wonderful friends. They are like family. Amen. They are family. Amen. Kindred spirits. Amen. Close together. And we're just so glad, amen, that they were willing to grace us with their presence tonight. Coming down all the way from the great city of Quinnesec, Michigan. Amen. Up there preaching the gospel, doing a work for the Lord. And we're just so glad to have Elder and Sister Brown here tonight. Evangelist Brown, praise God. And without further ado, amen, I'm just so glad to be able to bring this great gospel preacher up here, amen, to preach the gospel to our church. We're going to ask if you will stand on your feet as we greet, amen, Elder James Brown. Amen. Can we greet him tonight with a great big hallelujah? God bless you.
Truly, God is good. And like the songwriter said, God is real. I just believe that God is going to grace his presence with us these next 3 days, because the evil one, the devil, tried his best to hinder us from coming down. But God is real. We had my car transmission issues. My wife's car, we let my daughter take to Champaign, Illinois on a recent move. And our van had brake issues. So how do we get here? But God is real. Yeah, we could have rented a car, yeah. But my son, that's a few miles away from us, allowed us to bring his car. Amen. Truly, God is real. And if I have to take a praise break, just excuse me. Because, like I said, the devil tried to hinder us from coming. Last night I was, it's cold up there already in the UP, and I was taking one of the window air conditionings out of our foster care, and I was transporting it down to the basement, and I missed a whole step, but God is real. I fell down the steps with the air conditioning in my hand. Although it was a window air conditioner, y'all know those things ain't light. But God is real. He purposed us to be here this weekend. Next thing I know, I was getting up, had the air conditioning still in my hand. We got a brand new facility in our foster care. Didn't break any walls. The air conditioning is still intact. And yours truly is here tonight. Don't tell me God ain't real. Hey! Tell me God ain't real. I owe him a praise. And you owe him a praise. Kind of getting ahead of myself. God is real. Truly, we thank God for your invitation. First of all, we give honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, our soon coming King. King of kings and Lord of lords. We certainly give honor to the pastor and first lady of this great assembly. I don't see Sister Richardson, but I'm sure, she's way in the back. Praise the Lord. Good to see you. And Pastor Richardson for inviting us down. We don't take it lightly. I was asking my wife, I said, I wonder why do they ask us to come down? In all the great preachers. So I'm humbled by this invitation, because I know you could have brought in some great preachers, but just pray with me and let God have his way. We give honor to your former pastor, Bishop Julian and Sister Julian. I don't see her in the house. In the kitchen, she's still working. They came all the way up north. We were in a Women's Day weekend.
Women's Day retreat. They graced us. I'm still happy here, feeling good. Your sisters, y'all know how to praise God. You know how the loud anointing. I'm not saying that we brothers can't do it either, but oh, we were blessed. Blessed that weekend. And we certainly thank God for the deacon board here, all the saints and friends, guests that might be in the house, our friend back here from Jackson. Amen. All right. My intention is not to leave anybody out. All the elders. Amen. Tweedell. Amen. And we certainly thank God for all the saints and friends. Last year I was here and I didn't bring, I forgot a towel. You know, when you're traveling 7.5, sometimes 8 hours. And I didn't have a towel. Elder Richardson let me use one of his. But before we left, he presented me with it. So I like to, gave me two of them. And I said, told my wife, I'm not even going to use it. Unless the Lord bless me to come back. I mean, I was so appreciative. It just hung in my office up north. I mean, you are some great people here. You're so thoughtful. I mean, I could have just used some paper towels, but Elder Richardson gave me one of his. Amen. So I appreciate that, but this means a lot to me. Thank you. And thank God for my lovely wife. Thirty-five years later, five kids later, six grandkids later, truly God is good. He's a blesser, and truly we are so appreciative. I don't plan to be, we just got off the road, literally just got off the road. We got a late start, and we made it to the hotel. And just in enough time to change and to make it to the church. So I promise I'll let you out by midnight. I promise. So I want you all to come back and be blessed of the Lord. But just like he tried to hinder us, some of us might have struggled to even get here today. Struggled during the week. I don't know what everybody is going through, but God is still God. And I don't know what he has in plan for us these 3 days, but somebody ought to tell that evil one, not today. Mm-mm. You can't have my blessing. Not today. You can't have my shout. Not today. You can't take my joy. Not today. Our Psalms, the Apostolic Psalms, Psalms 150. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Mm-hmm. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him for his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with the timbre and dance. Praise him with the string instruments and the organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. praise him upon the high sounding cymbals. And you know something? He didn't leave nobody out. Do you feel you got a little breath today? Because he said, let that breath praise ye the Lord. The thought for a few moments I'd like to leave with you is we are in a war. We are in a war. And the devil is throwing all kinds of guns, big guns at us. So since we are in a war, let us bring out our big guns. Let us bring out our big guns. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, I thank you. Give me strength today, oh God. Lord, you are a great God and none like you. The heavens declare your name. Men declare your name. All the animals praise you. The trees praise you. Oh God, give us strength this evening. The render a just praise unto you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh God, revive us. Send down your anointing. Give us that freedom. Lord Jesus, allow us to lay aside every sin, every weight that so easily beset us. Oh God, and we will thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. We are in a war. So thereby, let us bring out the big guns. These last days, we are in a battle for our very life. The devil is throwing and bringing everything our way. Why? To trip us up. And over time, his mission is to stop us from serving and walking with our God. And in some places, he's doing a very good job. Now, in these last days, the devil is not using 22s on us. He has brought out his big guns. He's throwing all kinds of pain our way. All kinds of family issues our way. He's throwing discouragement our way. And you know something? He is not playing tiddlywinks. He's on a mission to destroy, if he could, every one of us, including elders and pastors. If he can get us first, if I can bind a strong man. I don't know about you.
He ain't touching this. That's right. I'm praying for you. You pray for me.
And you ought to tell somebody next to you, he ain't touching this. He's throwing resentment our way. Chaos. Throwing it at us.
He's throwing agony at us. Somebody might even say, if it wasn't for bad luck, I would have no luck at all. Well, I just stopped by to tell somebody that Jesus, he don't use any lucky rabbit's feet. Jesus don't use no four-leaf clovers. He just uses his awesome power to bless us. So if you got any of those rabbit feet, four-leaf clovers, throw them away. Jesus said, I'll tell you what to put on. Because we're in a war zone. He said, finally, my brethren, put on the whole armor of God. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Just get a new change of clothing. Just put on that whole armor. Don't leave none of it off. Like they used to say, don't leave home without it, because you're going to need it in these last days. That you be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. In these last days, he's throwing out some mighty big guns against God's people. Now, the fact that some of us are facing financial hardships, the devil is throwing that in your face, causing us to forget that God has already said in Philippians that our God will supply our every need according to his riches in Christ Jesus. Now unto God and our Father, be glory forever. Amen. In other words, if God said it, I believe it, and that settles it. Amen. He's able. Although the devil is throwing some big stuff our way, if we can just focus on the word of God, we can't help to be blessed. If we can just keep our eyes on the prize. But nonetheless,
that's right.
The devil keeps aiming his big guns at every one of us. Excuse me for pointing. His big guns are targeted towards you. But he keeps throwing them at us. All kinds of stuff our way. In his efforts, what we need to do is know our enemy and understand just because we defeat him today, he's coming back tomorrow. And it might just bring a bigger gun to the battle tomorrow. Or should I say, a bigger problem. He might get in the kids. He might just get in the wife. He might get in the husband. He might even get in the brother, the sister, causing strife in the church. Know your enemy. Your brother, your sister is not your enemy. Your boss is not your enemy. We might feel that he is. Your companion is not your enemy. Because who God put together, let no man put asunder. So your companion, your husband, or your wife is not your enemy.
Come on now, preach it.
We might be our own worst enemy.
That's true.
But understand this, that the devil is our biggest enemy.
True.
Amen.
Paul said in Ephesians, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you be able to quench all the fiery darts of the devil. So don't look at your brother, your sister. That arrow ain't coming from them.
Come on now.
What you're battling with is what you can't see, flesh and blood. It's not your enemy. You can't see the enemy, but the things you are facing, they're real. The fiery darts are real. The headaches are real. The marital problems are real. The financial situation is real. The problem child, the problem wife, the problem husband, they're real. The boss, he's real. He's no figment of your imagination, but he's not your enemy. The pain, both physical and psychologically, is real. And it's tearing you asunder. The Lord is just saying, just go about your daily activities, but be vigilant like they did in Nehemiah's time.
Amen.
The Bible says they that builded the wall, they bear burdens. With one hand they build, but in the other hand, they carried the sword. Everyone that builded had a sword girded on his side. And he kept on working. And Nehemiah said it like this. He that was by my side, he blew the trumpet. He sounded the trumpet. He was right there by my side. And I just stopped by to tell somebody that we're blowing the trumpet. I'm sounding the trumpet. It's time to tell the devil what you're doing to me. This means war. And you keep messing with me, I'll remind you, I got my war clothes on. Tell that devil, you can't have my blessing. You can't have my family. You can't have my wife. You can't have my husband. You can't have my increase. You can't have it.
Amen.
Say it like you mean it.
You can't have
it. I got power. And you know something? I got some big guns too. I just stopped by for a few minutes to tell somebody that no weapon formed against thee shall prosper. This is the heritage. No, nothing that's formed against you.
Nothing.
And everything that rise up against you in judgment. God said, I'm going to condemn it. This is our heritage. This is our righteousness. I know the devil is using some big guns. But somebody ought to tell the devil, just keep messing with me, and I'll bring out my big guns. In my day, back in the day, I used to carry a 44 mag. And all I would do is open my jacket and flash it and tell somebody, you mess with me and I'll set you free. Now, I don't flash anymore because you might see that tire in the middle. So I keep my jacket tied up now. Now understand this. That's yesterday. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of every stronghold. Now we cannot defeat the devil with bad language. We can't shoot the devil with a 44. You can't even use kung fu on the devil.
Come on now, talk about it.
But we can defeat him. Through our God, we can bring down every stronghold. Break every yoke. Every problem. This or that.
Right.
It doesn't matter to Jesus. Just give me a few more minutes.
Take your time.
Before World War II, we was not classified as a mighty nation. But when Japan attacked Pearl Harbor, the Emperor of Japan said, oh no, we just awoken a sleeping giant. The devil don't want you to awake yourselves.
Come on now.
And to realize who you are. So in these last days, he's throwing or shooting some big guns at us. Trouble. Trouble here. Trouble there. Trouble everywhere.
Come on now, talk about it.
So much trouble. He ain't playing. He's shooting some big guns. Through our troubles, the devil is winning. Yes, right. Help us, Lord. By keeping us depressed, despondent, dejected. Some of us might even feel rejected or neglected. We might even feel our very lives are in chaos. But somebody ought to realize that's not our heritage. Mm-mm. We are apostolics. We are what God made us. That is to praise Him no matter what. Especially for what he has done for us. Now God told Moses, tell the people. And I just stopped by to tell somebody, to remind us what God told Israel in the 10th chapter of the book of Deuteronomy. He said, therefore, you were a stranger, talking to Israel. You were in the land of Egypt. In other words, God don't want you to ever forget it was I that brought you out of the land of bondage. We owe him some praise. He told Moses, you tell the people, Israel is my praise. And also, he is your God, Israel. But just so, if somebody forgot, since yesterday, since last week, he's your God too. God said, Moses, just remind them, your fathers went down to Egypt, yes, with 75 souls. But when they came out, it was so many of them. The book of Numbers, who they only counted men, counted 603,000. Now, if you count the women, the children, the concubine, some estimates put that at 2 to 3 million folk. It was more in multitude, the Bible says, as the sands of the sea, stars of multitude. The devil was after God's people even then. Even against Israel, the devil brought out some big guns. But my God, he brought out bigger guns, and he defeated the devil and everybody that walked with him. He finished Egypt off at the Red Sea. And you should be reminded that the devil, he's been after us ever since we went down in Jesus' name. Ever since he filled us, God filled us with the Holy Ghost. Ever since he brought us out. For us, this thing started with Jesus. When God brought forth his big gun in his son, Jesus. They attached Jesus to the cross. But Jesus was God's praise. He said, look at my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. If we can just muster up a praise despite what we're going through, we are well pleasing in God's sight. It ain't no telling what God will do. Just when I'm getting ready to wrap her up. Just when the devil thought he had Jesus at the cross. I feel like taking a praise break. God said, wait a minute. Hold on. It ain't happening, Lucifer. It ain't happening. It ain't over until I say it's over. In our situation, it ain't over until God said it's over. Despite what the devil might say, despite what the devil might do, Jesus, who was God's praise, got up out of that grave. Yes, he did. The devil thought he had him, and he thought he had you. Oh, excuse me for pointing. Woo! Jesus got up in victory. Then it went back to glory. But then God sent back another big gun. And it started in Jerusalem. 3,000 souls. 5,000 souls. Filled with the Holy Ghost. All the way down the 44th Street. Anybody here got the Holy Ghost? If you got the Holy Ghost, you ought to reach out to somebody and tell them, I got power. We're in a war. And we ought to bring out time to bring out the big guns. And like I said, when Japan attacked Pearl Harbor, the emperor said, we just woke up a sleeping giant. We need to wake up and to realize who we are and what we are and what kind of weapon God gave us when he gave us the Holy Ghost. We are God's weapon, the weapon of praise. Can't nobody praise God like the apostolics. I need to keep going. The United States after Pearl Harbor. They said, how dare you? How dare you attack us? We're going to rise up. And that they did. We're going to fight you. And we're going to fight everybody that's on your side. Italy, Germany. Just like Joshua said. Well, who's on the Lord's side? Anybody here tonight on the Lord's side? So the United States began to build big weapons of war. The 155 howitzers, tanks. But the biggest and one of the baddest weapons they built was the battleships. The mighty fighting machines of the day. They had aircraft, anti-aircraft guns on them. They had all kinds of guns. But the biggest gun that was on that battleship is what they called the 20-inch guns. It could shoot out of a projectile. The weight of a small car. It could stand 25 to 30 miles out in the ocean and hit a target on land with pinpoint accuracy. The big 20-inch guns. It sounded like thunder. When that weapon was fired. And that's what we got to do. Before I close this thing, let's unleash some big guns. It was fearsome, that battleship. But the enemy was still powerful. The United States said, well, we got to build more and more battleships.
And pretty soon, they had enough battleships that they named after every state in the Union. Search your history. The only battleship of a state that wasn't named was Hawaii and Alaska, because they wasn't states in that day. But the biggest battleship, the baddest one, was the USS Iowa, the USS Missouri, the USS New Jersey. And I think I see some New Jerseys and some Missouris, in the house tonight. Even, oh yes, with all those big guns, they were still, the country was losing soldiers by the hundreds, by the thousands, until they said, let's unleash the biggest gun yet, that atomic bomb. Oh, I'm not proud of that thing. But when they dropped that bomb in Hiroshima and Nagasaki, it was over. Well, anybody tired today? Anybody weary today? You ought to tell that devil, it's over. I have had enough. You ought to think about what Jennifer Lopez said. Enough! I got some big guns too. When we brought out those big guns during World War II, the enemy finally surrendered and said, we have had enough. Well, the enemy, if you will just do the right thing, praise is one of the biggest and baddest weapons that God gave us. When the United States built all those battleships and named them after every state in the Union, what they were saying is this: you mess with any of us, now you has messed with all of us. I don't care if you're from New Jersey, if you are in the United States, you have messed with all of us. And it doesn't matter if the devil is messing with you, he's messing with me too. Hallelujah. We are brothers and sisters in the Lord. Do you feel united tonight? Do you feel, look what has happened on the day of Pentecost when all those folk were together? When the devil is messing with any of us, boy, girl, woman, or man, he's messing with all of us. The Bible says in Jeremiah, the 51st chapter, thou art my battle axe and my weapons of war. God said, I'm going to break in pieces every stronghold. And with my will, God said, I'm going to break in pieces the chariots and his rider. In other words, anything that comes against you, God said, I'm going to destroy. I'm going to break in pieces. God said in Jeremiah, the men and the women that come up against my people, all I want you to do is praise me. I'm telling you, you don't imagine, you can't even imagine in your mind what God will do if we would just do the right thing, just like the Bible said.
hallelujah. Oh, for the spirit of heaviness, put on the garment of praise. Hallelujah. Trade just like you trade in that old car. Put something new on. Put some God in that place of sadness. Put on gladness. Hopelessness. Put on hope. Sorrow. Pain. Put on a new garment. Hallelujah. Because Jesus is in the house tonight. Somebody may not feel like praising God. Somebody may not feel, oh God, well, this is that that God promised. Hallelujah. When you're in prison, you might not feel like praising God. Hallelujah. You might not feel like praising God when you're in the midst of the fire. But if we can muster up a praise, hallelujah. Whoso the Bible says offers praise, glorify me. God said, oh God, Psalmist said, let the people praise thee. Let the people praise them. Hallelujah. God will begin to work. Hallelujah. I might feel like I'm about to die in my body. Hallelujah. But I have to muster up enough strength and tell the devil, enough, enough, enough. You can't have, you can't have my praise. We got to be like that big battleship and send out. We got some big guns too. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm reminded of the time during Jehoshaphat's day. Oh God, oh God, when the children of Ammon and the Amorites and the Moabites came up against God's people. Hallelujah. The people was scared. The people was weary. The people, even Jehoshaphat, he was shaking. But at least he did the right thing. He sought God. He went to God. He said, oh Lord, what shall I do? After consulting with God, the Bible said, oh God, the Bible said, this is what I want you to do. Oh King, I want you to go out tomorrow at this time. I'm going to give you the victory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He could have. We told Jehoshaphat, hallelujah, this is what I want you to do. I want you to get the singers. I want you to get the timber, get the musicians, get somebody that can make a joyful noise unto me. Get somebody that don't is not worried what it looks like. Get somebody that's not afraid to step out. Get somebody that will go and march and march into the enemy. No weapon formed against you will prosper. Now he could have, God could have asked Jehoshaphat to get the men of war, get the chariots, get the ones with the bow and arrows, get the ones with the weapons of war. But God said, I need a praise. I need a praise. The battle is not yours. The battle is not yours. I'm going to fight for you. I'm going to fight for you. The battle is not yours. Hallelujah. On the day of Pentecost, God saw us 2,000 years later, and God said, enough of this. I'm going to unleash a big gun on the devil. The Holy Ghost. God said, after that, when you get it, you will have power to stand against the wiles of the adversary. Anybody got the Holy Ghost tonight? Anybody else? Come on, instrument players. Come on, somebody. Anybody got a timbre? Anybody is not afraid to be seen in the house? The victory is in your praise. God said, just praise me. You want victory over your finances. You want victory over that husband. You want victory over that wife, over that child. Just stand up and walk out. Walk forth and give God a praise. We got some big guns, dude. Oh, magnify. All you gotta do is open your mouth. That's a big gun. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in the sanctuary. Praise God. Hallelujah. For his mighty acts, praise God according to his excellent greatness. Let everything. Somebody ought to think of just one thing that God most recently have done for you. You heard me say last night, hallelujah, I missed the whole step and fail. But look at me now. You ought to tell somebody, look at me now. I was in darkness, sinking in sin, seeking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard my. God said, don't ever forget. Told Israel, don't ever forget. And he's telling us, don't ever forget. Don't ever forget. You remember what he did for you yesterday?
Yes.
Last week?
Thank you, Jesus.
Last month?
Hallelujah.
Had he done anything? Somebody ought to stand. I'm not trying to make you shout. I'm just trying to tell you that you ought to praise him, because God is an awesome God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
God is a wonder. Oh, ye people, praise me. God said, oh, yes. I know we had some mighty good chicken and some mighty good fish, but forget about that meal for a second. Just forget about it. And just begin to praise him. Thank you, Lord. Woo. It's time. It's time. It's time. Just to take a praise break. Kids, all right? Is that all right? Is that all right? Is that all right? Is that all right? Hallelujah. Just put the mic down. Put your problems down. Put the pain down. Put the headaches down. Put the hardships down. And just get up. Anybody tired of the devil's junk? Anybody here tonight need the Holy Ghost? Come on, somebody. God is on his way back. If you need the Holy Ghost, you need to come. Hallelujah. If you need a refreshing, you need to come. Hallelujah. Don't you feel the Lord in the air? He's coming. He's coming for a church that's ready. Hallelujah. Not getting ready. Ready. You ought to come. Come running for your life. Like your life depended on it. Because it does.